Good evening, everyone. We'd like to get started. Mrs. Sandow is a real tickler for getting started on time so we can end on time, so we want to make sure. I left my glasses at home, so I have to read something a little bit bigger than I normally did. Lucky I know a little bit about computers. I was able to double the size of the font. First of all, I want to welcome everyone here. It's a great pleasure for all of us to see you here. It's important for kids to see their parents and grandparents and friends and neighbors to be part of something that's really special. I'm sure that the performance tonight will equal the performance this afternoon, which was just outstanding. Mr. Stoetzel is taping this video, this program. It will be broadcasted. He said probably will start tomorrow on Channel 3, which is the Menomonee Falls cable program. And if you don't live in the falls but would like a copy of it, maybe you could call up a friend or neighbor, or we will be given a copy of it. Okay, and then you can tape off of the one that we've received. So if you really would like one, it'll run like from now until Christmas, so there's plenty of time to get a tape. Also, I've been asked to kind of remind everybody that there are cookbooks for sale. Some of St. Anthony's finest recipes are there, and you have to pay a lot more than $10 to get them individually. So if you really want to get some really great recipes, the cookbooks are for sale. There's also a donation box for our drama department, and we would certainly appreciate any donations that you could make to it. We're going to be putting on a spring musical based on art, and you know how hard it is to build an art. So if you can help us out, we'd appreciate that. I have a little prayer, and then I'm going to hand the program over to Mrs. Sandow. But rather than do it at the end of the program, I'm going to do it at the beginning of the program this year. And it goes something like this. Every time a hand reaches out to help another, that's Christmas. Every time someone puts anger aside and strives for understanding, that's Christmas. Every time people forget their differences and realize their love for each other, that's Christmas. Our wish for all of you is God's caring, peace, and most of all, love. Have a blessed Christmas and a joyous new year from St. Anthony's school family.
Thank you. their Christmas program entitled The Wonder of Christmas. So just sit back and relax. We would like it if you too can share this wonder of Christmas.
Mine is crazy.
Yes, that's right, crazy. Very disconcerting.
Disconcerting?
It means taxes.
No, it means, that's what I'm going to draw. Taxes. I've been trying to think of something that would make Mary and Joseph seem real. Haven't you ever wondered if they got excited or did crazy things? I want my picture to be real, so I'm going to draw taxes.
Harry, you're weird. Christmas has nothing to do with taxes. Nobody pays taxes until April.
That's all you know. Everybody's always paying taxes. Even Adam and Eve. Because taxes are real. My dad says they're the realest thing in the world.
I'll bet they did. I'll bet that's why they got thrown out of the garden and beat it, because they couldn't pay their taxes.
Harvey, that's ridiculous.
Harvey may not be read the book Adam and Eve, but taxes are a part of the Christmas story. Don't you remember it said, and they all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city. And Joseph also went from Galilee into the city of David, which is called Bethlehem.
City of David? You know, that's pretty cool to have the city named after you. I'd start calling this city of Todd, which is called Menomonee Falls.
You're as bad as Harvey. No worse.
I'm sorry to interrupt. Does anyone know what waddling clothes look like?
I know.
Well, I do. They're little pieces of cloth. Mother's wrapping around babies real tight so the kids couldn't get it. Extraordinary.
How do you know that?
My grandmother told me. She says they ought to start doing it again. To teenagers.
Harvey, can't you ever be serious?
I am serious. That's what she said.
I've got a question too. I know smart stuff, Harvey. What's myrrh?
It's a reddish brown gum that comes out of a tray.
Why don't you forget myrrh and just put some good stuff like gold? Just everyone needs money even back then.
You could in other things, make it more real.
That would be an advantage.
I knew that. Suppose you were the wise man and you had to choose. Well, let's just say right now you had to choose a gift for the whole world. What would it be?
That's easy. Money.
I'd give everybody a home.
I'd make everybody healthy.
Well, I've got a better one. Peace. I'd give everybody peace for Christmas.
That's commendable, Harvey. But how would you do that?
Thank you.
story. Maybe I'll think of something.
Thank you. Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring things of great joy which shall be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is this shall be assigned to you. They wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in the house, there is sent to the heavenly host, praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, good will to men.
Departed. Many knights, the star was David, seen in the east, went before them.
until it came to the place where the young child was. And when they had entered the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented gifts to him, gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Thank you.
God bless you all.
Mm-hmm.